Hey guys, I hope you're doing fine. This is Ankit Bhatia and welcome back to my channel. Now today we're going to talk everything about export settings, but before that let me tell you one thing, that I just got these lights and first time I'm recording my videos in a studio light. And let me know how is it looking, like how my face is looking. This light is so soft, you know, and I'm not getting any shadows on my face, and I know that my background is not that good. I still have to work on it and I'm gonna work on it. We are growing, right? Okay, so let's talk about export settings. You know, whenever you upload a video on YouTube or Instagram, it always compresses the quality. So I'm gonna tell you a best way to export it from the Premiere Pro for YouTube and Instagram, and also I'm gonna tell you about the custom resolution export. Like for Instagram, I always export in vertical format, and let's say for YouTube you want to export in some custom resolution, maybe you know, and upload in 1080p. And also if you want to export an image from the project, that's what I'm gonna tell you as well. So let's go to Premiere Pro and start the tutorial. But wait, before that, let's roll an intro. So let's say this is your project and you're done with the project. Now you want to export it for YouTube, for Instagram, or maybe you want to export a thumbnail. Then first of all, we're going to start with the YouTube. So let's go to the file menu, go to export and go to media. So the first thing that you have to do here is go to the format and find this H.264, select this one, and then go to the preset. Here you will find a lot of preset. Now if you're uploading in 4K, then you have to select the last option, YouTube 2160p 4K. If 1080p, then select this option. I always upload in 1080p, so I'm gonna select this option. Then select export video, export audio. Make sure that you have selected both these options, and then give it a name as well. Select a folder and let's say export video. Okay. Now go to the video section, check your basic video settings. Make sure this is selected, 1920/1080p, and then click this option, render at maximum depth. Now go to the encoding setting. If it's selected as software only, then select hardware accelerated. This will give you some fast rendering, and then select high, and then level is 4.2 is fine. So these should be your encoding settings. And now go to the bitrate setting and make sure that 16 is selected. I always use 16. Sometime you may see this number as 10, but make sure to select this as your 16. If not, just type in 16. And VBR 1 pass is fine, and rest everything is fine. Now go to the audio settings. Here select the audio format as AAC. Once you have selected this, go to sample rate and select the maximum sample rate possible. Here for me it's 48,000 hertz, so you'll get the good quality of the voice. And select the channel as stereo, that's fine. And then select the audio quality as high, bitrate as 320, and that's all you have to select. Also select this option, use maximum render quality, and use previews. This option will also make your rendering a little bit faster, because it will use those previews to render your videos, so it's gonna be a little bit faster. And that's all, just click export and this will export the video. So that's what I use for YouTube. Now one more thing is, if you don't want to export in 1080p settings, let's say you wanna change the resolution, then what you need to do is just select cancel. And let's say you want to crop it a bit, and I'm gonna select as 13 here and 13 bottom. Let's say you want to export only in this resolution, so what you need to do is go to the export settings again, and you see this option source, click this option, crop the output video, just hit this and just crop it. That's it, 1920x800 pixels, that's what we have selected. So if you want to export in this setting, then go to the video option and uncheck this and type the same number here as 800. So now this will export the video only in this format. So that's how you can export in custom resolution as well. Okay, click cancel. Now let's talk about exporting the video for Instagram. So for Instagram export, what I do is I always export in vertical format. So that's the maximum space on Instagram you get for videos. So we're gonna create that right now. So first of all, make this as 0. 0. So what we're gonna do is, for Instagram export, first I'm gonna select in the vertical format. Now for this, I'll go to the left and I'll select the option as 27.5 and right as 27.5. So once I've selected that, I'm gonna export only this video. But before that, what I'll do is I'll shift all these videos, small videos, so I'll get the proper framing. So just go here and reposition this. See, that's how we'll get all in the middle. You can do the same, and just gonna reposition all the video. So once you have repositioned all those videos, then go to File, Export and Media, and do the same thing here that we did for YouTube. Like select here and just go here and select YouTube and check all the settings that we have done, like use maximum render quality, use previews, render at maximum depth, and go to audio and check that. Yeah, it's already done. So the only thing we have to do here is just select the source, crop it accordingly, select this. And so this is really important step if you want to do custom resolution export, otherwise it will always export in the default format. This is the resolution that we have created, 864 by 1080p. I always export in this format, 864 by 1080p. So go to the video and now go here, select the width as 864. Earlier for YouTube custom resolution we change height, here we're changing the width. And if the checkmark box is checked, you have to first uncheck and then type in here as 864. So after doing that, you can hit export and it will export the video for Instagram. So that's what I do for Instagram. Is now the last thing is, let's say you want to export the custom thumbnail from here. So what you need to do here, just disable this first and make it as 960. Now for custom thumbnail, or let's say if you want to export the picture from the video, what you need to do is, you see this checkbox export frame, if you don't see this, go to the plus option, you will see here. Okay, so click this and select the JPEG as option and let's say export picture and select the browsing folder and just click OK. So that are my export settings. So guys, that's all about this video. I hope you like it, and if you do, then hit a like button and subscribe to the channel if you aren't already, and hit that bell icon as well so that we will be communicating on weekly basis and you won't miss any of my notifications. And also let me know like how this studio light is looking on my face, and if it's good, then I will make a video on that as well. So with that said, I'll see you next time. Till then, take care, bye bye.